time in a good survival kit in a place like this is quite essential. Today, I'm going to show you my survival kit when I go out and hike and stuff like that. Bike ride. Because you never know. And something can happen. Like your bike tire could just pop. And you could get lost easily if you don't look where you're going. So this could get you through that time. First off, we have 2 water bottles, 500 milliliters each. It'll probably last you about maybe a day or two if you ration it right. Next, for some protection from the sun, you got a little multifunction head cap. So you could easily just put it right over and it could protect your neck and protect all the your face and stuff like that if you do it right. That's much better to have a hat. This is almost like a handkerchief, but it's a tube. It's pretty good. Next, have a multi-tool for doing basic stuff. You could do carvings. It has a good knife on it, and plus it locks in. That's a great knife. Half serrated. Next, signaling you or keeping track where you've been. Got some flagging tape, just put it on a branch, it tells where you've been. And plus, if you write stuff, you could write the time that you were at that time at that point. And then, if a search party is looking for you, they know how much it's been passed since you've been there. Next, I have my little multi-tool, actually. It's kind of cheap, but it's the only thing I could get a saw. It's a pretty good saw, but could have better. Next, more signaling. I got my Starflash Ultra Signal Mirror. Got a little hole right here, you can see what you're pointing at. And plus I put this little neck lanyard. So it's easily holdable. Next, for fire, I got a container full of striking wire matches. About 20 of them. Never hurts to have something with fire. Next, toilet paper. You can start fires with it. Do the plenty of stuff with it. And of course part of it. For dental hygiene, I got dental floss and toothpicks. Does it just get that squirrel or rabbit out of your teeth? And plus with the toothpicks you can start a fire easier. And with the dental floss, it doesn't have to be just for used for that. You can use it for snares as well if you don't have the fishing line, which is what's next. I got 100 yards of monofilament fishing line, and you could put like plenty of snares with this. Next, fire. You get a spark light. Shoots pretty good sparks. Or you could just right onto a piece of cotton. This goes right up. Next, for food, I got a Nature Valley bar. Won't last much, but it's better than nothing. Next, I got this bag. It's a pretty big bag. You could collect water with it. You could stuff leaves into it. You just gather a bunch of stuff. You can use for insulation. You can make it like cool other things like a shelter, but it's not much for shelter. But it's better than nothing. That's what I would say. Next, handkerchief. Usually used for fire, since it's 100% cotton. You could filter the water with it. You could use it for as a bandage. And just plenty of uses. Next, I have the survival compass whistle. It's pretty good. Yeah, but it's much better to carry two compasses. Reason for that is if a lot of people get out of doubt if their compass is actually working, so having two, it just points to the same direction as they are, north that way. So it's always good to have at least two compasses. And plus this one is a multi-function, so it's much better. It's signal and direction. And also has a magnifying glass on it. So you can start that fire right up if you have some cotton or some of that. Next, have some fire sticks. So you could actually eat that rabbit that you caught. This just starts it really well. It's not as good for starting up really quick, but it gets the job done. Bonus is it's waterproof. Next, emergency space blanket. Even though you think you're still in the desert, you still need something to protect you from the dew, or it gets pretty cold in the desert sometimes. And you'll be lucky to have that. Next, hooded poncho. It's not just for rain. You use this for like a solar still. You just dig your hole, put this right over it. And just put a little bit of water on the bottom of it. Have a little cup or something like that. You can just get a whole bunch of water. That's thinking out of the box. Next, pretty good flashlight to see stuff in the dark. Next, about 100 feet of paracord. Paracord's just really strong, it won't fail. It really helps. And that seems to be it. If you have any comments, put them down below. Any suggestions, please leave your thoughts. Thank you. See you next time.